Before time began, there was the Cube.
These were the first seven words uttered in Michael Bay's live-action vision for the Transformers franchise. For many fans, this was a bittersweet moment. On one hand, you were greeted by a familiar voice, Peter Cullen, the original voice of Optimus Prime. On the other hand, you had the feeling that your childhood was about to get raped. Many of us here at Culture Junkies feel that Michael Bay is doing a pretty good job with the Transformers brand, and that all of the hatred and anger that comes from the fans is a little misplaced. Sure, the second film was kind of weak, but all the nods to the true fans of the series that occurred in the third film kind of made up for it. Besides, like it or not, the three Transformers films have grossed over $2.6 billion worldwide. Now we're about to get the fourth installment with the release of Transformers Age of Extinction. In honor of the film's release, not to mention their own product placement, GM has put up a Transformers display in their headquarters located in Detroit, Michigan. The lobby of the Renaissance Center's Winter Garden has become a temporary home for Optimus Prime, Bumblebee, as well as Bumblebee's 2014 Camero vehicle mode and the 2014 Corvette Stingray, which is the vehicle mode for the new character, Crosshairs. Detroit has also stood as a fill-in for China in the film, with some of the principal filming taking place in the heart of the Motor City. Kids, adults, and families have gathered for a chance to take photos with Optimus and Bumblebee, and we're sure some of the grown-ups were equally excited about the new models for the Camaro and Corvette. So whether you love Michael Bay or hate him, you can't deny that he's tapping to the pulse of something big. And besides, you were going to go see the film either way. This is GQ, and this has been your Movies Fix.